Welcome back to Business AM. We're still on by telling you exactly what is going on in the country right now. Now, the Central Bank of Kenya has announced that Cooperative Bank of Kenya's intention to acquire 100% stake in Jamimbora Bank. However, this will be subjected to the following conditions. Number one, usual due diligence by the relevant professionals. Now, the board of directors and shareholders' approval by both lenders, regulatory approvals by CBK, Capital Markets Authority, and the Competition Authority of Kenya, CAK. Now, the cash-strapped Jamimbora Bank has been on the brink of collapse, with the Commercial Bank of Africa, CBA, initially set to acquire it earlier in 2019 with a cash offer of $1.4 billion. However, the acquisition was thrown into shambles after CBA merged with NIC Bank. Now, as of 31st December 2019, Coop Bank was ranked fourth out of the 39 banks in terms of market share in Kenya, with JBB being ranked at 38 out of 39. Fantastic. That's exactly what it is that we're talking about this morning as regards this deal. It's going to go on. Of course, we do expect. Even Patrick Njoroge himself has come out and said, well, we like this sort of direction. This is a way to sanitize the banking sector in the country. But I want to point you out to exactly what has also happened immediately, Abraham, after this announcement came through. United South. They announced that our move to run with the Central Bank of Kenya, telling them that they're now ready to transition into a bank in the country, have been turned down. And the only reason that was there, the Central Bank told them, well, that period to do that expired back in September 2018. So you can't move on to be registered as a bank as we do not of it today. You gotta wait. And that process is gonna start all over again. Is that what CBK wants? Look, no more banks.
Yeah.
What we have is good. Let's talk about more marginal acquisitions. That's exactly what it is that we're touting for.
First of all, let me declare my interest. I have worked for both Cooperative Bank and Jamimbora Bank.
Yes.
That is for the record.
Yes.
Now, if you look at, let's compare a few economies. If you look at Nigeria, Nigeria has 200 million people, has 25 banks. South Africa has 58 million people, has 21 banks. So that means Nigeria, for every 8 million people, there's one bank. In South Africa, it's about 2.5 million people per bank. Kenya, we have 47 million, and we have about 44 banks, plus the commercial, plus other financial institutions.
Yes.
That means in Kenya, it's one bank, 1 million people. So if we were to transition to what the ratio Nigeria is at, we'd only need six banks.
Yes.
So what am I saying? What I'm saying is that we probably are overbanked. If you compare the two big economies in Africa, their ratios are between 7 million and 3 million people per bank.
Yes.
So for us to transition even to 3 million people, we would have to half the number of banks we have in this country.
Yes.
That's why Dr. Njoroge is very keen when he hears this kind of thing.
Yes.
Where KCB is buying NBK, where Cooperative Bank is buying Jamimbora, and others.
Yes.
And he'll be very hostile. Maybe hostile is a very extreme word, but yes, he'll be very, very hostile to anybody trying to bring in a new bank.
Yes.
Because that's not the direction he wants.
Abraham, and I know we spoke about this in the whole of 2019, you and I about this, but there's the other side of the argument as well.
Yeah.
That if the banking sector, as we do know of it today, is overly regulated by the Central Bank of Kenya, there are also arguments for both ends as well.
Yeah.
And if all these other banks, the smaller banks as we call them in the country, do meet the threshold to be called banks as well, then why is the argument for overbanking if Jamimbora Bank, as we don't know if it has 350,000 clients, has still been able to move on forward with his business according to the CBK thresholds? It's fine, isn't it? So what is the other side of having lesser banks in an economy? That's what the other analysts also look at it and say, well, we also have to talk about the other side of this equation as well.
It's purely business.
Because
if you're down to 1 million people per bank, it means that you'll struggle for business. You see, Jamimbora is not selling because they want to sell.
Yes.
Because they are struggling. And you can see that they have been basically been struggling.
Yes.
And that's the issue. The Kenyan market is only so big. So in any market, can only take so many players.
Yes.
And this has been said before, we will probably have more banks than we need.
Mm-hmm.
Because Even if you look at the concentration, the top 6 or 8 banks probably control over 60-70% of the market.
Yes.
So the other guys are just struggling for these other things. So they are barely making it. And even their books, if you compare the tier 2 going down, it's a real struggle.
Yes.
It's only the big boys who really are, and you can see it's still the big boys who are buying the smaller ones.
Yes.
So the concentration to me, in my opinion, is not a bad thing. Because if you go and start a new bank now, for you to grow, a good example, like for example, the other day, Mayfair is selling out. Mayfair Bank, probably yes. you've heard about it. They started, they have struggled, and now they're selling out. It is very difficult to enter this market because these big guys have basically dominated this market. Mm-hmm. So the only way of survival of these smaller guys is for either them to come together or bring in a big partner and become a big guy,
yes.
or sell to the big boys.
Yes.
Yeah, but for me, trying to get a new partner, even issuing a new license,
yes.
is not even fair to the person you're issuing it to.
Yes. Which therefore makes sense for us to look at the next story this morning that I have for you this morning, because we do know that KCB has also completed also the buyout yes. of National Bank yes. this morning, which is good according to CBK, Governor Patrick Njoroge.
Yes.
But I want to ask you though, is this what we expected now, Abraham, after the cap on interest rates was repealed? Because the celebration was these other smaller banks then could find a way to position themselves correctly within the market. And the big boys, I would like to point you out with what the CEO, KCB, said immediately after the cap on interest rate was repealed. He actually even said the 20% interest rate regime
is gone.
Is gone.
Yes.
Are the big boys directing business in this sector within this economy? Because you would like to think that upon the repeal of the cap on interest rates, then the smaller boys could position themselves correctly. I mean, sell themselves to the customer, come up with products that were supposed to talk to their customers directly, that will remain profitable.
You see, as I told you, the big boys, the 5-6 top banks,
yes.
are basically what in economics we called an oligopoly.
Yes.
Oligopoly is a good, is just a soft term for a cartel.
Yes.
So oligopoly is a group of top guys who come together and basically control the market.
Yes.
Which is what they actually, so if they don't go up, nobody can dare go up. But having said that, I think the direction has to continue, that the smaller guys have to find ways of strengthening themselves to stay relevant in this market.
Yes.
Because you can see the bigger boys are working on getting stronger. They already yes. are strong.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, KCB has acquired a fairly big bank, National Bank. So that means that their muscle increases.
Yes.
Now, CoBank is about to take another bank on board. So so everybody seems to be expanding. Now, Barclays has turned to Absa. So Absa has a big muscle behind them. You see, so if you look at these big boys, they are all very, very strong.
Yes.
So these are smaller guys have to look for ways of surviving this market. Don't forget, for you to lend, there are certain ratios you must adhere to.
Mm-hmm.
And one of those ratios is pegged on the deposits you are able to mobilize. Now, that's another problem. There's this tag in the market that people feel safer putting their money in the bigger banks.
Yes.
So you see, also the deposits are skewed towards. So if you have less deposits, you lend less. When you lend less, you make less money towards your fixed deposit, your fixed costs. And when you can't beat your fixed costs, then you're not making money. You're not breaking even. So for those thresholds to go up, your deposits must come in. For deposits to come in, people must perceive you to be stronger.
Yes.
So whichever way you run it, they have to be perceived as a stronger person. So either you come together or you bring in a stronger partner.
Yes.
Yeah.
But now, the complaints that are coming in, and I want to point you out to also the CEO for APSA now. Last year, he did say, well, the way it is that we're going on with this business in the country, that we are overly regulated. The best way out for the smaller boys, is it to get acquired? Because it seems like, because we were talking about Transnational Bank, which was also acquired the other day, now we're talking about Jamii Bora Bank. Mm-hmm. We do expect more, as well as we do go on this air. The best way out, is it to merge or to get acquired by the bigger boys?
But
I see the trend now.
Yeah, whatever works for them.
Yes.
You see, but I think a strategic partner would be better, because when you get a strategic partner, you probably will keep some of your stake.
Yes.
But when you're acquired, you see these guys are acquiring 100%.
100%.
Yeah, the big boys, they take you in and you lose
yes.
your identity.
Yes.
Even National Bank, it was just a strategic decision that was made.
Just to have the name National Bank really not go out.
But for 2 years,
yes.
and then
yes.
review.
Yes.
And I think after the 2 years, that brand will just disappear.
Yes.
Yeah.
pretty much, isn't it? Yeah. All right, so we expect to see more mergers and acquisitions in and this yes. post-Red Card region?
Because you can see that if the governor is at the front of that of that call, yes. it's going to happen.
Pretty much, yeah. pretty much. Abraham, thank you very much for joining us this morning. I am sorry we don't have time for the next issue this morning, but guess what? Tech Abraham, to the first time that he walked into the studio this morning, talking about how the Kenyan economy is shaping this morning, on YouTube at Metropole TVKE. We are at Metropole TVKE. Yes, on Facebook and Twitter. I am a Charles _ Kenyage. Talk to him also. 20, that is 20146. That is our SMS line. But once we come back, therefore, we are asking, what is the best way to advertise online? And we're talking about picking the best influencer for your product. Once we come back.